गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल. माई सेल्फ नितिशा सोनी, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन नर्सिंग डिपार्टमेंट फ्रॉम आर पे IIMS बस्ताड़ा करनाल. टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट एक्यूट रेनल फेलियर. नाउ लेट बी स्टार्ट. डेफिनेशन: एक्यूट रेनल फेलियर इज अ सीवियर डिटेरियरेशन ऑफ रेनल फंक्शन मैन्युफैक्चर्ड एज अ सडन रिडक्शन ऑफ यूरिन एक्सक्रीशन लेस देन 1 ml पर kg पर आवर्स एज ओलिग्यूरिया और एन्यूरिया लीडिंग टू फ्लूड एंड इलेक्ट्रोलाइट्स इम्बेलेंस एंड एकोमुलेशन ऑफ मेटाबॉलिक नाइट्रोजीनस वेस्ट एंड अदर बायोकेमिकल प्रोडक्ट. इट इज अ लाइफ थ्रेटनिंग सिचुएशन. नेक्स्ट वन इज इटियोलॉजी. द कॉज ऑफ एक्यूट रेनल फेलियर कैन बी डिवाइडेड इंटू 3 ग्रुप्स: प्री रेनल, इंट्रा रेनल एंड पोस्ट रेनल. Prerenal causes: these conditions are related to the problems occurring in blood supply to the kidney either due to systematic hypovolemia or due to renal hyperperfusion. The important causes are hypovolemia due to diarrheal dehydration, shock, burn, diabetes, acidosis, trauma, hemorrhage, etc. and CCF. Next one is intrarenal causes. These intrinsic renal conditions are related to problem within the kidney and their function causing reduction of GFR. GFR means glomerular filtration rate, renal ischemia and tubular damage, renal vein thrombosis, sepsis, interstitial nephritis. Next one is post-renal causes. These conditions are related to the problems of the ureter or lower urinary system causing obstruction of urinary flow due to obstructive uropathies. Causes include renal calculus, PUV, bladder neck obstruction, congenital lesion, pus collection in urinary tract. Next one is phases of acute renal failure. 4 phases of acute renal failure are identified in children depending upon the causes of illness. First one, intestinal phase. Intestinal phase means this phase lasts from hours to days with feature of renal function impairment. Oliguria phase. This phase lasts from 5 to 15 days but can be prolonged for week. It is shorter in infant and children, 3 to 5 days. More than 3 weeks duration of oliguric phase indicate irreversible renal damage. It depends upon severity and durations of initial stage causing acute vasoseptic nephropathy. Diuretic phase. This phase lasts for few days and highly variable with mild to severe clinical feature. Recover phase. This phase marks the final resumption of normal urine osmolarity, constituents and biochemical alteration in the blood. Next one is clinical manifestation. There are many clinical manifestations in duration of the problem. First is, the child may present with severe oliguria or anuria. In some case, urine output may not be reduced. The child looks remarkable well or extremely sick. Nausea, vomiting, lethargy, dehydration, alteration of level of consciousness, irregularities in cardiac rate and rhythm, edema. Next one is diagnostic evaluation. There are many diagnostic evaluations depending upon clinical finding. Blood examination shows raised serum creatinine and urea level as important criteria for diagnosis. Blood CBC, electrolytes, pH, bicarbonate count are also useful. Urine examination reveal proteinuria, hematuria and presence of cast. USG help to detect the structural abnormalities, calculi, etc. IVP can done to detect acute tubular necrosis. KUB X-ray is done. Next one is management. They are peritoneal dialysis and hemofiltration dialysis. The purpose of dialysis is to remove endogenous and exogenous toxic and maintain fluid electrolytes and acid-base balance until renal function recover. Indications: severe or persistent hyperkalemia, congestive heart failure, pulmonary edema and severe acidosis. Peritoneal dialysis advantages: peritoneal dialysis does not require vascular access or sophisticated equipment and is easy to perform even in neonates, so this make it the preferred dialysis procedure in children. Chronic PD is done through a 10 cough catheter. procedure. The abdominal skin is prepared as for a surgical procedure. After ensuring that the bladder is empty, lignocaine is inflated in the midline at a point midway between the umbilicus and pubic symphysis. Dialysis fluid 20 ml per kg is infused to distend the peritoneal cavity. A small incision is made in the skin and linea alba and the peritoneal catheter introduce bulu into the pericolic catheter. It is fixed to the skin with perfusing suture. The dialysis fluid is infused 30 to 50 ml per kg, lift in the peritoneal cavity for 30 to 40 minutes, then allowed to flow using a siphon effect into the drowning bottle. The entire system is kept as an air-free closed system. 30 to 40 cycles are carried out. The duration of dialysis is usually 10 to 12 hours a day, duration which 4 cycles and performed. Potassium is not added in first 5 to 10 cycles to enable correction of hyperkalemia. Later, 3 to 4 mEq per liter potassium children is added to the dialysis fluid. Next one is complication. The most important and common complication is peritonitis is nursing management for peritoneal dialysis. Before procedure, preparing the client for the dialysis by explanation and encouraging to the express feeling, allowing to talk to other child who have undergoing dialysis. Next one is obtaining informed consent for the procedure, ensuring that all blood examination report are available with the child before dialysis, protecting child from infection. After procedure, symptomatic and supportive nursing management measure before the and after dialysis to be proved, along with promotion of self-care, teaching the parents and family members regarding dialysis, should dietary restrictions, medications, prevention of infection, possible complication, regular follow-up. Hemodialysis, it permits effective removal or of excess fluid as protein-free plasma. It is necessary to have vascular access with large size catheter to allow blood inflow and outflow. Hemofiltration is particularly useful for the management of patient with severe fluid overload. The procedure is all.